Starting off, let's start with the twins Ty and Cade Rutolo recap Cade's world title winning performance against Wally Kerzhev in the ONE Championship. With an impressive record of being undefeated since earning his black belt in late 2021, Cade Rutolo has proven himself to be a top-tier grappler in the world of martial arts. The recent concluded event of the ONE Championship saw him claim the title of an inaugural lightweight submission grappling world champion by defeating the multiple-time Sambo world champion Wally Kerzhev. In display of pure dominance, Rutolo showcased his unparalleled grappling skills by executing a perfect heel hook, leaving Kerzhev with no choice but to submit. It was almost a moment of sheer brilliance that will undoubtedly go down in the history of martial arts. To delve deeper into this epic moment, Cade Rutolo and his twin brother Ty, who is also a ONE Championship submission grappling athlete, sat down for an exclusive interview on Prime Video 3 where they recap Cade's highlight-worthy win.
The second the match actually starts, all the pressure goes away because then it's just the real threat at hand, you know? The second the match actually starts, all the pressure goes away because then it's just the real threat at hand, you know?
Halfway through the 10-minute submission-only encounter, Rutolo had the upper hand and was on the lookout for an opening to finish the fight. As he attempted to pass Kerzhev's guard with a leg drag, Rutolo found himself in a deep leg entanglement, but he quickly capitalized on the opportunity and executed a picture-perfect belly-down heel hook, forcing Kerzhev to submit. Reflecting on the win, Cade expressed his disbelief at how far he had come.
It's crazy because, you know, heel hooks used to be our weaknesses a couple years ago, and now we're starting to finish a lot of fights with them.
Cade's win over Kerzhev was not his first triumph of the year. He had previously made history by becoming the youngest competitor to win gold at the 2022 ADCC World Championships. In the final of the 77-kilogram division, Cade utilized the same belly-down heel hook to submit Mika Galvao. While his next appearance in the ONE Championship is not yet scheduled, Cade's stellar performance has cemented him as a force to be reckoned with in the world of martial arts. With his unmatched skill and unwavering determination, there is no telling what heights he will reach in the future. But who do you think Cade Rutolo should face next as he continues to dominate in his division? Let us know in the comments below. The highly anticipated return of UFC color commentator Joe Rogan to the table at UFC 287 was a treat for many MMA fans. Rogan's busy schedule often prevents him from attending UFC events outside the US, leaving fans yearning for his voice and expert commentary. Aside from his return to the commentary table, Rogan recently released a new episode of his highly popular podcast, The Joe Rogan Experience. In this episode, Rogan was joined by a talented comedian writer, Sam Talent, for a lively discussion covering a wide range of topics. As the conversation progressed, Talent revealed his experiences in wrestling, which piqued Rogan's interest. Always eager to learn more about martial arts, Rogan delved deeper into Talent's background, and in an unexpected twist, the podcaster also shared a surprising piece of trivia about the world of jiu-jitsu. Curious about his guest's experience with the sport, Rogan asked Sam Talent if he has ever trained in jiu-jitsu. To Rogan's surprise, Talent admitted to avoiding the sport, citing his aversion to violence. "I don't have that bloodlust," Talent stated, much to Rogan's amusement. Rogan was quick to clarify that jiu-jitsu is not a violent sport, but did acknowledge that the risk of injury is high. In fact, Rogan went on to describe an incident where a jiu-jitsu coach faced a lawsuit after unintentionally causing a severe injury to one of his students. The incident, of course, is about Francisco Giraldi, a second-degree black belt who had a freak accident with one of his students, rendering the student a quadriplegic in the process. Rogan described, "This guy who is a jiu-jitsu coach, I think it happened in California, and he did like a forward roll with a guy to take his back, and the guy's neck got caught in a bad situation, and he snapped his neck." He further revealed, "The guy got nerve damage and paralysis, and he just got awarded $46 million. The former martial artist also revealed how getting seriously injured was an unfortunate aspect of jiu-jitsu that you're occasionally going to get. Most JRE fans know that Rogan was also once a martial artist and had trained in multiple disciplines over a long period of time. As such, his opinions definitely hold weight in such cases. This incident, however, has set a precedent throughout the country, and BJJ practitioners will be more cautious moving forward in their practice sessions." For the time being, let's move on to the next news of our day, where we will see Marcus Buchecha preview grappling matches set to take place on May 5th for ONE Fight Night 10. Buchecha, one of the most successful BJJ competitors of all time, is now a heavyweight MMA competitor for ONE Championship. As an expert in the world of grappling, he recently sat down with an interviewer at ONE Championship to share his insights on the upcoming grappling matches scheduled for the event. The first match on the card features Buchecha's close friend, Ty Rutolo, taking on current one middleweight MMA world champion Rainer DeRuyter. Although Rutolo boasts significantly more experience in grappling competitions, the match is expected to be a closely contested affair. Buchecha spoke candidly about his relationship with Rutolo, noting that they have trained together on numerous occasions. That's going to be a really good one, and it's going to be a tricky fight for both of them. You know, me and the Rutolo brothers were friends for a long time, and I met these kids when they were like green belts, and back in the day, we were from the same team, RVCA team, and I just had the opportunity to train with Rainer only one time, so I know more about Tai's game. It's going to be a good one. While DeRuyter may not have much experience in jiu-jitsu as his opponent, his training with top-tier partners at New Wave Jiu-Jitsu is sure to bring some unexpected surprises to the mat. Buchecha himself has faith in his old training partner, confident that he is keeping up with the new and younger game. I know DeRuyter is going to camps in America, and he's trying to keep up with the younger game and newer game, so that's why I think he's not going to get left behind on the new games, the new technique, this kind of stuff. Next up, Buchecha previewed Mikey Musumeci vs. Osmai Almawai. Musumeci will be defending his flyweight submission grappling world championship against Almawai, and Buchecha completely has a winner in mind. For sure, fighting against a champ like Mikey would be a really tough job, because Mikey is something special for sure. The kid, he sees jiu-jitsu in a different way. He thinks so fast and he makes decisions really fast in a fight, and I think that's something amazing to watch. So I think it's going to be a great fight, but I think Mikey's going to keep the belt. Marcus Buchecha Almeida didn't just predict the outcome of the grappling matches at One Fight Night 10 though, as he also had an unexpected prediction on how he sees Musumeci winning. Being honest, his passing game is really good. He has a really good technique for passing. We don't see him much on the top, but once he gets on the top, for sure we're going to see a lot of pressure, and I think that's because he wants to test himself, so we're going to see a lot of top game for sure. But what do you think about Buchecha's prediction for One Fight Night 10? Do you agree with him on most of them? Be sure to sound off in the comments down below. And of course, while you're at it, we'd love to know whether you enjoyed the video so far. If so, please subscribe to Valor Strategy Grappling and hit the bell icon so you don't miss out on the upcoming videos. With that being said, let's move on to our next news of the day. Lachlan Giles has just announced that he'll be charged of $100,000 fund that has been created to help the growth of jiu-jitsu in Australia. The news was announced that Giles, in a private Australian BJJ community on Facebook, where he outlined the details on how the fund will be put to use. As per his post, the funds will be distributed to active competitors who are succeeding at the highest levels of the world's most prestigious tournaments. While there are no restrictions on what athletes can spend money on, Giles has outlined various criteria that will be used to determine the worthy recipients of the fund. The possibilities are endless, ranging from covering the cost of traveling to major tournaments, supporting full-time training, or even opening a new gym in a location where one does not currently exist. As one of Australia's most successful BJJ competitors, Giles is passionate about supporting the growth and development of the sport in his home country. Alongside Craig Jones, who has been supporting local athletes, this fund is said to be a significant boost to the jiu-jitsu community in Australia. It remains to be seen how Giles will allocate the remaining half of the fund, but it's clear that this is an exceptional opportunity for high-level jiu-jitsu competitors in Australia. Are you excited about the future of BJJ in Australia and what this fund will lead to? Be sure to share your excitement with us in the comments below. Demetrius Johnson is on the home stretch of his preparations for his upcoming fight, and he's ready to show some improvements on May 5th. The flyweight world champion is no stranger to intense training regimens, and he's been hard at work preparing for this fight with his team at GRPL Club in Washington. Johnson recently shared a photo of himself with his team on his Instagram page, showing off their dedication and hard work in the lead up to the big event. Last hard grappling session with at GRPL Club. Love the community and team. Excited to represent the team May 5th, tagging ONE Championship and Prime Video's official accounts as well. Demetrius Johnson's ground game will be crucial if he is to overcome Adriano Moraes at the ONE Fight Night 10. While Johnson is a brown belt in jiu-jitsu, his opponent is a BJJ black belt and has won half of his 20 wins via submission. Interestingly, both fighters knocked each other out with devastating knees in their previous two meetings, which were the first knockouts of their respective careers. It was worth noting that both fighters have a tendency to grapple with their opponents, so there's a good chance that the next fight could end up on the ground. One thing's for certain, however, is that Johnson and Moraes will be looking to put an end to their rivalry once and for all. One Fight Night 10 is already sold out at the First Bank Center in Colorado, but fans in North America can still watch the action live and for free on Prime Video with an active Amazon subscription. Who are you predicting to win the One Fight Night 10? Demetrius Johnson or Adriano Moraes? Sound off in the comments below. As for the last news of the day, we're going to be going over the upcoming BJJ Stars 10 Battlefield, which is slated to have one of the most seismic and unpredictable open weight brackets in recent history. The event, which takes place April 22nd in Sao Paulo, Brazil, features a 16-man absolute bracket with $40,000 on the line. Here are the details of the bracket. The tournament will have four IBJJF World Champions, gold medalists from other major events, and the current BJJ Stars middleweight champion. The top 8 athletes have already been seeded into two categories, with the top 5 including Mika Galvão, the reigning BJJ Stars middleweight champion, and four IBJJF World Champions, Kanan Duarte, Victor Hugo, Eric Muniz, and Felipe Andrew. The other three top-seeded athletes are the Brasileiro's champions of the years past, Gutenberg Pereira, Mauricio Oliveira, and Patrick Gaudio. These remaining 8 athletes will each face one of the top-seeded athletes first. 3 of them are IBJJF Pan's champions and are guaranteed to match up with one of the 3 Brasileiro's champions in the first round, including Adam Wardzinski, Roberto Cyborg Abreu, and Devontae Johnson. The remaining 5 athletes who have not earned a major black belt title will be pitted against one of the top 5 seeds in the first round. The specific first round matchups will be drawn from a hat during the live weigh-ins on Friday, April 21st, which can be viewed on BJJ Stars' YouTube and Instagram pages. And that concludes our news recap for today. What was the highlight of today's roundup? Be sure to let us know in the comments below.